بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته Dear students, welcome back to the online class 10th class computer chapter number 2 programming in C language and today we have lecture number 10 so Let's start our lecture. In our previous lecture, we discussed about the main function, the body of the main functions, and constant and variables. And today we discuss about the data types which we used in the C language. And we also discuss about the different types of the data. And also discuss about the integer and floating point data types. So let's start our lecture. First of all, in C language, how many types of data type we use? So C language provide us three main data types for variables. So first is integer, second is floating point, and third is character variable. In our previous lecture, we learned that integer, floating point, and character. But in that lecture, we learned integer as the constant, floating point as constant, and character as constant. Okay? So, you know that in previous lecture, we discussed about the integer constant and floating point constant. And we also discussed about the character variable, string variable, okay? But today we discuss about the integer data type, floating point data type, and character data type variables. Now, first is integer data type. Now, what do you mean by the integer data type? Integer data type means, first of all, by the name integer. We know that what is mean by the integer. Okay, because in previous lecture we learned about the integer in detail. Simply we can say that a number which does not contain the point, that is the integer number. So integer data type must link with the integer constant. It means in integer data type we have the numbers which don't have the point, okay? Because we know that what is the integer constant, okay? Integer data type is linked with the integer constants. So, first of all, type specifier variable, how we write the variable int sum. That is the syntax for declaration of the variable with the data type. Now, as we know that in our previous lecture, or we done the sum algorithms in the unit number 1, we write the sum equals to a plus b. But we don't declare the variables. We only write the sum equals to a plus b. We don't know what is the sum, floating point or integer. But whenever we have to write a program in C language, we have to declare the variable first. Okay? For declaring the variable, we need two things. First is data type, and second thing is the name of the variable. First is data type, and second thing is the name of the variable. Int represents the data type and sum represents the name of the variable. It means whenever we have the int product, int average, int sum, float average, float percentage, anything, float height weight. So first word is the data type and second word is the variable name. Whenever we have to declare the variable, declaration of the variable consists of two parts. First is the data type, and second is the name of the variable. Okay, now this. So always in declaration of variable, we have two things, data type and name of variable. Now, whenever we have to use the variable in C language, we must declare the variable before use. If we don't declare the variable in the program, so compiler cannot run the program because compiler find the error because we don't declare the variable. Okay, now in some programs we may contain more than one variables, as here we have the variable int sum, but in some program maybe we have int sum, product, average. Okay, int sum, product, and average. So how we write these three variable names? So if we have the more than one variable in a C language program, so we can write them as int sum, comma, second variable name, comma, third variable name, comma, fourth variable name, up to so on. And at the end, we have to add the semicolon. Let's take an example. Let's suppose we have int and variable A. Okay, so then B, then C, then D, then E. Okay, up to so on. How many variables you have in the program? You can write like this pattern. First variable name, comma, second variable name, comma, third variable name, and at the end, if you have the variable Z, so at the end, if you write the comma, so your declaration will be wrong. Or if you write only Z, so it again becomes wrong. So at the end of the variable, you have to write the semicolon. Okay? If you write the semicolon, then it will be your correct declaration of variables. I hope now you understand how we write the more than many variables with the single int. Or second method is you can write here int int A, then int B, and then int C. Up to so on. Okay, but we don't add, if we write the int A, B, C, D like this pattern, so it will consume our time and memory also. And we have to write the more step of instructions. Let's suppose we have the 10 variables, and if we write int A, int B, int C, int D, int E, int F, so it takes a lot of time, and it also consume the memory, and we have to write the large number of instructions in one program. So that's why we don't adopt this method. We only use this method, int A, B, C, D, E, up to so on, and at the end, we put the semicolon. Very simple. Okay? Here is int A, B, sum, product, semicolon. There is another example which is given in your notebook of the computer. Okay? Now, when we declare the variable, let's suppose int A, B, sum, and product. So, first name is the data type, int, that is the data type. Now, A declares the variable name, but int data type. B also declares the variable name. and some also declare the variable name, and product also tell us the variable name, and these all four the variables have the same data type int. Okay, if we have the int a, b, c, d, e, so it means all the variable have the same data type, which is int, which is written before the name of the variables. Now another problem, if we have the two or three variables with the same name, let's suppose we have the variable int a b, okay, and we also have the a b. Now what will happen if we have the two variable with the same name? So in this type of situations our program will not run, because in a single program we can write a variable name one time, not more than one time. Means every variable name must be unique. Every variable name must be unique. AB, so we write AB first time, not the more than one time. Okay. Another problem is, let's suppose you write the int and product. Int product. And after some time, when you write the program on the line number 10, okay, you can write product PRODCT, okay, equal to A asterisk B semicolon. So when you write the int product semicolon, and after some time you can write here when we use the variable A asterisk B. Okay, now what will happen? You know that we have declared the int product, and here is the spelling the product PRODUCT, but when we write the product we write PRODCT. U is missing. Okay, so if you write the wrong variable name which you declare with the int, so program gives you error and compiler asks you to declare the variable product PRODCT. Okay, let's suppose here you write the int and you write average. Average. Okay, now after some time if you write the complete average, if you write the ever, okay, equals to something, let's suppose 500 divided by 3, so it again give you the error, because we don't declare the ever, we declare here int average. So if we use here average, so compiler does not give you error, but if you write the variable name other than the you declare in the first step, so compiler gives you the error. So these type of problems may occur when you run the programs. Okay, all the problems we discuss here. Now let's start the next. Declaration of an integer variable can begin with the type qualifier short, long, unsigned or signed. Some examples are, main data type is int, but in some situations we write short int, long int, unsigned int. Okay, so what is the purpose of these short int, long int, unsigned int? Why we use the word short, long, unsigned? That is the question in your minds. So now we use the short, long, unsigned because in some situations we have to store the huge value in num or huge value in sum or average. Let's suppose if we have the box in memory, let's suppose that is the RAM or memory in which we have the variable sum. Okay, so when we can store here the numbers between 0 to 1000. Okay, but after 0 to 1000, if we write 1001, so we cannot store in the sum. So what will happen? So that's why we use the short, long, and unsigned. It means short can gives you the more space than int, and long int gives you the as much more space than the short. Now, why we use the short, long, unsigned? Because these short, long, unsigned have the greater value or greater memory storage in the memory. So if we have to store the large number in a variable, so we can write the short or long. So now, next question is, how much memory can consume the short, long, and unsigned in the memory? That is the next question in your minds. Okay, so first of all, short, unsigned int, I tell you, int or short int, 2 bytes, and long ints, 4 bytes. It can take the 4 bytes in the memory, and unsigned int contains 2 bytes. Now,